Desalination, the conversion of salt water into fresh water, has been limited by high operational costs. A new device capable of turning desalination waste into commercially valuable chemicals could make the process cheaper and more environmentally friendly. Taking a new approach to an old problem, Stanford researchers have created a device that could make converting seawater to freshwater profitable and environmentally friendly. Their research, published in ACS Sustainable Chemistry and Engineering, outlines an efficient method for transforming water with very high concentrations of salt and chemicals, known as brine, into commercially valuable chemicals as part of the desalination process. The approach avoids the need for disposing potentially hazardous chemicals in local ecosystems. Desalination could be a powerful tool to mitigate water scarcity around the world, but it is limited by energetic and monetary costs for treatment and brine management. Desalination plants around the world produce about 27 billion gallons of drinking water each day. That is more than the daily total used by all US households. However, this draft-proof approach of converting brackish or salt water to potable water is costly because it requires a lot of energy. It also produces about 1.5 times more brine than potable water. For their new study, the researchers designed and tested a device that splits the components of brine through a method called electrochemical water salt splitting. Water salt splitting separates the brine into positively charged sodium and negatively charged chlorine ions with the use of an electrochemical cell, that is, a device that employs electrical energy to kickstart chemical reactions. Once the bonds are broken, sodium and chlorine combine with the other elements to form new chemicals, including sodium hydroxide, hydrogen, and hydrochloric acid. Sodium hydroxide, also known as lye, is used in the manufacturing of many products, including soap, paper, aluminum, detergents, and explosives. Hydrogen has primarily been used for industrial purposes such as fertilizer production and energy storage and delivery. Hydrochloric acid is used broadly across commercial industries as a component in battery production, as a food additive, and even in leather processing. It also has the added benefit of on-site use for cleaning at desalination plants. The new approach could also help cut brine disposal costs, which can account for up to a third of total desalination expenses and avoid damaging environmental impacts. Current brine disposal methods can cause salinity and acidity spikes along with oxygen deficient conditions in waterways that kill or drive off animal and plant species. While the current study did not produce chemical solutions suitable for commercial use, they were more diluted. The researchers note this is a first step in providing a foundation to inform future design and operation of electrochemical water salt splitting. The researchers plan to continue their work while partnering with desalination plants to advance energy and cost efficiency.